My name is Ben Busby. I'm the Genomics Outreach Coordinator for NCBI. Joining me on the line are Peter Cooper from the NCBI Education Group, as well as Jeremy from CyVerse, as well as Pat from MOTHUR. Today, I'm going to tell you about five ways to submit to NCBI's SRA. This is not an exhaustive list, but a list which we are aware of. If you have another submission platform or offers this as a service, we'd love to hear about it. Please send us an email at webinars@ncbi. First, we'll talk about BaseSpace. We'll mention independent consultants. An example of this, although we certainly don't endorse them, is Base2Bio. MOTHUR is a platform for submitting metagenomic analyses and raw metagenomic data. Then we'll talk about CyVerse, formerly iPlant, possibly known to many of you as iPlant. And then finally, we'll talk about the NCBI Direct Submission Portal and some updates that we've been doing recently, some of which have come out today. So many of you are probably familiar with BaseSpace. It's a very large platform run by Illumina, which is a private company. And it's trivial to upload data from Illumina sequencing machines to BaseSpace. What you may not know is that you can easily import samples to SRA, or I'm sorry, into BaseSpace from SRA, and you can also load samples to NCBI from BaseSpace using the SRA submission app. Typically, BaseSpace does not have the metadata required for SRA. So BaseSpace provides an input form with submission and sample details, and then everything is submitted to SRA. Here's additional information in case you want to talk to BaseSpace about your submissions or simply get more information. As I mentioned earlier, MOTHUR is a resource with many, many tools for analyzing 16S type sequences. It's the most cited tool for analyzing 16S ribosomal RNA gene sequences, and it's completely open source, operating system independent. Deposition of 16S is challenging for many users. That's why many of you are listening to this webinar. MOTHUR worked with the SRA staff to make a customized portal, and so far a lot of data has been submitted. You can check out all of this on the MOTHUR wiki. All you need to do is provide the necessary MeMarks metadata with the Get MeMarks package and a PubMed Central or an article that's been deposited to PubMed Central about MeMarks. There's a link provided here. You can check out what MeWorks is. Then, if you give all the necessary metadata to MOTHUR, then MOTHUR will submit that along with the data to SRA. Finally, you just need to give it a little bit of information about yourself. CyVerse, formerly known as iPlant, is a large NSF-funded mandate to support lots of life science, hence why they change their name from iPlant, in my personal opinion. And if you have any questions about this, you can contact Jeremy at this email address. CyVerse has a discovery environment, which is built on the iRODS platform. It supports many bioinformatics applications and also has a lot of data. Via this discovery environment, you can submit to SRA, and checksums and all that are automatically created by CyVerse. You can also create or update bioprojects as well as biosamples. So here's a pipeline view of the CyVerse-enabled SRA submission. And there are efficient both command line as well as GUI tools for submitting to SRA. Also, you can put in the bioproject and biosample and all the sequencing metadata via templates. And those templates are simply uploaded from the NCBI templates, which I'll talk about in a little bit. Finally, we can use the contact email to transfer ownership over to your NCBI account. But the discovery environment will retrieve an error report, and so you can correct things and resubmit them. I've been asked to mention that anyone can use CyVerse for free upon creating an account. Finally, I'd like to talk a little bit about the NCBI submission portal. This is under continuous development, and if you have comments about the submission portal, please send them to Layla Rossi at this address at NCBI. I'm going to talk a little bit about BioProject, then a little bit about BioSample, then I will talk about the new submission portal-mediated SRA submissions. The first thing that you would do if you were submitting through NCBI submission portal is to submit a BioProject. So first, we would just need a little bit of personal information to attribute your submission to, and also to be able to contact you should we have any questions. Next, you would give us the name of your organism or a mix thereof, and a technical overview of your data generation, including some specifics about sample prep, although you'll give other sort of ontology-based submission information in the SRA part of the submission. And if this is part of a research project, your research intent should be stated, as well as the relevance of your project. And there are many options there. After submitting a bio project, which is sort of like the specific aim for a grant, a whole bunch of things can go under there. Say, sequencing data, biological metadata that's submitted through BioSample, as well as links to other types of data that you might have DOIs for example. The next thing that you would do when going about one of these submissions, and you do this with the other submission pipelines we discussed, is to create a BioSample. In various ways, the other submission platforms have included the templates that we have for BioSample. One thing I suggest to all submitters is that if you want to submit to BioSample, Google for BioSample template, select the template that's appropriate for you, and look at what metadata, biological metadata, you need to collect before starting your submission. It's really important to note that from a user perspective, accurate and preferably ontology-mediated metadata is really crucial for adequate use. So please submit the most accurate and complete biological metadata that you can. After completing a bioproject and a biosample for each biological entity, then you would proceed through submission portal to submitting the SRA data. With the SRA data, we need a little bit of technical metadata, which can be submitted through either a tab-delimited file or an Excel spreadsheet like this one. Collection of the technical metadata is accomplished in a variety of ways with the other three platforms that I discussed earlier. Here we can see the Excel spreadsheet that can be downloaded from Submission Portal. And if you mouse over some of the descriptions, boxes will pop up describing exactly the information that's necessary to complete the submission. Finally, when you go to submit data files, it will bring up a directory and you can select the appropriate files to submit. I'd like to thank everybody for listening to this rather short webinar and thank all these people. On the line, like I said, I have Pat and Jeremy from MOTHUR and CyVerse, respectively, as well as Yuri Skripchenko from the SRA submission group. We'd be happy to answer any of your questions. What I'll do now is we'll select some of the questions, and I will either answer them myself, or I will read them to Pat and or Jeremy as appropriate. It looks like we've answered a bunch of technical questions. Are there any questions specifically about SRA? So someone had a question about what types of data are supported on SRA. So Illumina do account for many of our sequences. However, we support an enormous amount of next-generation sequencing platforms, including 454, PacBio, IonTorrent, and many other next-generation sequencing platforms. Pretty much anyone you can think of. And if your sequencing platform isn't supported, please send us an email at SRA at NCBI. At this point, there's a question about CyVerse. Somebody asked, is CyVerse for plant or all types of submission types? And I see that Jeremy answered it. All types of biosamples are submitted within the CyVerse pipeline now. Somebody had a question about logins, and that's something that's under active development. We're going to get back to you. We'll actually post the answers to those questions on our FTP site. Yes, this PowerPoint will be posted to the NCBI FTP site. The easiest way to find it is to Google for NCBI webinars, and you'll be able to link to it from our webinars page. There is one more question. Do you need to generate a new biosample for each sample submitted with a bioproject? The answer is, for each distinct biological entity, say you're submitting three types of cell lines for a bioproject, you would want to generate a biosample for each of those. However, if you have technical replicates within one particular biological entity, then you would not want to generate a new biosample for those. You do not need to provide an MD5 checksum for each FASTQ. Checksums need to be generated. That's in the SRA submission documentation. And as we mentioned, most of the external submission platforms will generate checksums for you. All right, great. Well, thank you, everyone, for attending, and I hope everyone has a fantastic week.